Moving along our color journey, today's focus is color blending. This feature is also part of the Effects tab, and we're going to start off with a simple matrix of circles to demonstrate what color blending does. So I'm going to create 5 shapes in a row and duplicate them 5 times. All right, now we need to add a few more color variations, so let me select the shape in each corner and give them some random hues so we can properly experiment with color blending. Let's go to the Effects tab. As a reminder, it's the 4th tab in the color picker, and here they are. We have 3 modes. If we want to blend horizontally, select any objects distributed in a horizontal line and tap on this button. Here's how it looks if we do it vertically. What happens in this operation is that the beginning and end colors define the spectrum of hues for all the shapes in between. It's really the easiest way to create new color palettes that are unique and harmonious. The last blending mode is called front to back, which means that we need to create a stack of objects. So let's reorganize our shapes a bit, delete the rest, and resize the 3 we selected. So now cyan is on top of the orange, which is on top of fuchsia. Let's select all and see the results. Vectornator blended the start and end colors and matched the contrast, saturation, and brightness to create the resulting hue, from top to bottom. And the result is pretty cool. Hope you're going to have fun with this feature. Our last episode will showcase the ins and outs of gradients, so be sure to check it out.